That's amazing. Okay, I will not use the advanced efficiency mode anymore. Hi everybody, welcome back to Anything That Moves. I'm Thomas. In today's short episode, I'd like to talk about the advanced efficiency mode in the Alfa Romeo Stelvio Quadrifoglio in this car. Those of you who are watching this video are probably know that there are four different driving modes on the Quadrifoglio. That is the advanced efficiency, the natural, the dynamic, and the race mode. So, in this episode, I'd like to focus on the advanced efficiency, which I've been using quite a lot until recently, and I will explain to you later why I'm not using it anymore. So, advanced efficiency, what does it do? Well, there's actually, I would say, what I can see is there are like three or four different things that will be affected by the by being at an advanced efficiency. That is the gearing. So when you accelerate, it will always gear up a lot earlier, and it will stay in as high gear as possible all the time. The acceleration is still quite reasonable. The other thing is the throttle response, and it kind of goes together with the gearing. The pedal travel, you have to push the pedal a lot more for something to happen than if you're in any other mode. Sometimes, even if you floor it, it doesn't really take off the way you expect it to. So that's just how it is. Now, the third thing is the freewheeling or the coasting function, which I've been, it provides for quite a comfortable ride, but from a fuel-saving perspective, I'm a little bit skeptical. Let's see. I'll talk about everything on this before. And then, of course, we have the last one, and that is this cylinder deactivation. It goes down from six cylinders to only three cylinders if certain conditions are met. Okay, so there's really not much to say about the gearing. Also not about the throttle response. What I would like to say about the freewheeling or the coasting function, and I know a lot of people, they think that is the most fuel efficient way of always driving. You know, it's like if you have a manual gearbox that you declutch when you're going downhill or something. But the truth of the matter is that when you let go of the gas, yes, it will go down. The revs will be lower than if you stay in gear. But let's say if you go downhill and if it's still clutched in, if you are like I'm doing all the time, I always have this instant consumption, meter on the meter. So what you will see is that if you're in the gear and going downhill, the instant consumption will go down to zero. While if it's declutching, if it's freewheeling or coasting, whatever you want to call it, then it's actually there's always some consumption. So in some cases it's good because maybe you want to increase speed or whatever when you're going downhill. You don't mind if your speed goes up a little bit, and then you will have that speed gain later on. But in most situations, actually, it's more efficient to stay in gear. So now my speed is too low, so it's actually not declutching or coasting. But I do like it in some ways because it's quite comfortable. It's kind of provides for a smooth ride. But And I would say that that is maybe the best, the benefit of the of being in the advanced efficiency, that the ride is very smooth. Now I'm going into a little bit more of a road, a little bit some more curves, so I will at least go to the natural mode. I think I've said what I can say about the freewheeling or the coasting function. I don't think it's saving you any fuel, that's my point. Then we have the last one, that is the cylinder deactivation. Now, there's a lot of conditions that have to be met for the cylinders to deactivate, and I haven't found any manual on the Stelvio Quadrifoglio automatic, but I found like a technical manual of the 6-speed manual Giulia Quadrifoglio, and I guess the principles of the cylinder deactivations are the same, so there might be some incorrect information in this, but anyway, number one, the coolant temperature needs to be between 50 and 110 degrees Celsius. On the manually geared Giulia Quadrifoglio, it should be in between third and sixth gear, so that would most likely correspond to fourth to eighth gear on the automatic 8-speed ZF box that is in this car. Next thing is that the cylinders are only deactivating up to 3,500 RPMs, and then above 3,500 RPMs you always have the 6 cylinders. Cylinder deactivation only takes place between 25 kilometers and 125 kilometers an hour, and there's also some, of course, something to do with the torque management, so regardless of what, they will not just deactivate it under any circumstance, you know, under any circumstance, you know, there's some from some torque prerequisite that have to be fulfilled. Okay, and then the other thing is that the cylinder deactivation will only maximum be active for 100 seconds. After that, the three cylinders that were deactivated will be reactivated, and then you will make a check again and see if all the prerequisites are fulfilled, and then it will once again it will deactivate the cylinders. Personally, I doubt that it actually gives that you actually have much benefit. I think maybe on the Giulia, because it's got lower air resistance and so on, maybe it's got more benefit. But you know, when you deactivate, you have actually a weaker engine. And if you're up, and let's say, if you're in higher speeds, as I said, it's only active until 125 kilometers an hour. But I mean, let's say if you're going around 110 kilometers an hour with an SUV, I don't think that you will. I think it's not really consuming less. You cannot really see when you have this instant consumption turn on. You cannot really see any benefit, and it is actually also quite difficult to tell when the three cylinders are deactivated. So it's difficult to judge actually. But now I'm not normally driving anymore, or normally I've been driving always, especially when we've been on road trips, so I've been driving in advanced efficiency, because I've been thinking, you know, at least it will save us a few drops of fuel. But the truth of the matter is that we made a road trip, a shorter road trip, maybe around let's say 800 kilometers a few days ago, and I decided, okay, I will try to go a little bit, you know, on the advanced efficiency. And the truth of the matter, I will go on the natural mode instead of the advanced efficiency. And then the truth of the matter was that I got the lower fuel consumption than I had on the, than we've had always. I mean, it was the lowest fuel consumption I've ever had on this car when I was driving in natural and not in advanced efficiency. So my conclusion is, with advanced efficiency, is if you if you're really trigger happy, you know, if you're really used to push a lot, you know, maybe it will save you a few drops, because it will actually not allow you to go, or it will not, maybe it will not respond that much to what you're doing when you gas, when you're in advanced efficiency. But if you can control your gas, if you know what you're doing, it seems for sure as if you can go more efficiently in natural mode than in advanced efficiency. My guess is that this advanced efficiency is just it's just some kind of thing, you know, to comply with the test, you know, to get the lowest consumption in the test cycle for the WLTP fuel consumption or something like that. But anyway, that's, I think, all I had to say about this advanced efficiency. So I'm not really using it anymore. And as you can see now, since this is still on the same average from our last road trip, we are averaging 8.9 kilometers per 100 kilometers. And this place, by the way, on the way to Skansundet, is the El Tomta Café, and they have really nice shrimp sandwiches here. Really nice. All right, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was interesting, and stay tuned for more videos to come. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Okay, just so we made another road trip. This time I decided to go on the natural mode instead of the advanced efficiency, and actually our fuel consumption has been lower than any of our previous road trips, which is kind of ridiculous. Huh? Look at this. Yeah, That's amazing. Okay, I will not use the advanced efficiency mode anymore.